United States. Six Olympic Games, Bill Steinkraus, which you can relate to. Here he is, hoping for the best of his team to be captains.
With a really critical round for the United States. This is the big casino starting now with Mike's round. There has been a little casino already in the battle for the bronze medal because Germany and France started only 2 points apart. France's last rider has not yet finished, but Germany's last rider has. All three of the last German riders had clear rounds. That means that France cannot catch them for the bronze medal.
The rider
Germany
and the
is
horse.
High and dry for the bronze.
Kay Bell and the rider and horse waiting for the tone, which you'll hear, not a bell, a tone, as we get a fine close-up of that 44-year-old horseman.
He did a wonderful job with this horse on the cross-country course on Wednesday. The horse is very inexperienced. Mike is very strong, very aggressive, really convinced the horse to jump at his best.
And Chris, as the trailblazer for the U.S. team, Mike started out without perhaps quite the team. Mike started out without perhaps quite the right shoeing. He didn't have any stickers in his shoes or any studs, and parts of the course proved to be quite slippery. The later riders then profited from that experience, and they were a little bit more appropriately shod.
Another example of teamwork going to number three now, Tad.
And teamwork is so important in this sport. And Mike is riding in typical American style, very smooth, very quiet.
Mike has said Bluestone can be a bully at times.
Little close to that one, but clear so far.
11-year-old gelding.
Really has the pressure on. Must go clean for the U.S. to remain in the position that it's in.
Just fractionally ahead of Great Britain, but Mike has had so much pressure so many times that there are very few people you'd like to see in that position more than he.
Horse is jumping very well.
No trouble with the hay rack. Well, maybe a little rub.
He gets a little bit on the forehand, this horse, and when you do, then they get close to the fences. These fences take a pretty good wallop. They're 15-foot rails, not 12-foot rails.
There.
And the 15-foot rails are heavier, so there have been a lot of clear rounds today, but there also have been a lot of horses had fences down.
You know, it's so hard for these horses to make this kind of effort after having done 17 miles yesterday in a marathon endurance cross-country course.
Coming up to 90 seconds on the course. He wants to be 120 or less, 120 seconds. That triple.
Jumping very well there. That's been giving some people trouble all day long.
And the audience roars its approval. Five penalty points.
Five at the last. What a heartbreak for Michael Plum. Bruce Davidson had it at Fairbanks with a problem at the seventh obstacle. The time, 106.86. You're allowed 120. So, Ted, it was one of the quickest rounds we've seen thus far now with eight riders to go.
That's right, Chris. There's no advantage in going under the time. You don't get any bonus points for going faster, but you must complete the course within 2 minutes.
The door opens a crack for the British team. The British team has been trailing by 8.2 penalty points.
Do we have
they now trail by 3.2 penalty points.
And you can see he just gives a little rub in front and then catches it behind. Not very hard, but just enough to come down.
Look at the look of Mike checking back to see whether it stayed or went.
What a disappointment.
Now at the tunnel at the far end of the arena, the stadium here, for the shoulder jumping phase. There's been dressage, there's been the test of